I've been coming to Lights to Remember from the very first year that Liz died. So that Liz died in August, and so that was only 4 months later I came to my first Lights to Remember. It was hard. It still is. I still find it very difficult. So emotive. But I wouldn't want to be anywhere else. My relationship with the hospice started with my sister 12 years ago. Mita was a patient here in the old hospice, so she passed away 12 years ago. And then my wife, Elizabeth, was in White Abbey Hospital when we were the hospice was there. So for 3 years, Liz attended the day patients and then passed away in the actual hospice itself. And then recently, I had a cousin, Harold, who died here in the new hospice. So yeah, 12 years of people in the hospice. When Liz was ill, and obviously her clothing wasn't fitting and things, we decided that my company that I work with, Edwards and Company, the solicitors, that we would take a shop in Castle Court, and we arranged to have it for a couple of days. And we got clothes and people brought them along. I thought all you had to do was just sort of hang the clothes in a hanger and sell them. But there was an awful lot more to it than that. And it took weeks of work getting them all steamed and labeled and hung and all the rest. And so the weekend we did the charity event, and we raised about £10,000 for the hospice. But then the hospice, Neil, decided he would keep the shop going. So to this day, 10 years later, the shop's still there. I find that everyone grieves differently. And so whatever way people are grieving, Lights to Remember is the place where they can do that, because no one's judging. No one's looking at you in any way. It's just somewhere where you're accepted and you handle your grief your way. I find it just wonderful to have the memories to think back and to see what the hospice is doing today, how it's still helping people and it's still there, and the service that it provides is just second to none.